Welcome to Channel 68 News for the week of October 26. I'm Gabe Rector.
And I'm Indigo.
Quote of the day, never let the fear of striking out get in your way. Zach Reyna. The Tyvee FFA. The Tyvee FFA will have their November meeting on November 2nd at 6 p.m. in room E115. We will be having our second annual Thanksgiving meal, so come and join us. This will also be stock show sign-up night from 5 to 7, so if you show an animal, you need to be in attendance.
Powell's Turkey Dinner Donations. Hey guys, this is Tyvee Powell's.
Gobble, gobble.
We are doing turkey dinner collections starting Monday through Friday. These collections will go to community members in need. Tyvee Powell's will be coming around to your classrooms during announcements to collect money. So if you have any extra change, help a family out this Thanksgiving season.
Tyvee Takeout. Attention teachers and staff, 67th Street is getting ready for Tyvee Takeout on November 5th. We will be serving chicken kebabs, cream corn, pasta salad, and ensalada de fruta con chili, all for $11. Follow our Instagram at 67th Street for more information, or see Chef Estrada in E106.
Now over to
the
channel 68
Sports.
Welcome everybody, welcome to Channel 68. My name is Tyler Smith, and today we're starting off with the Tyvee Antlers football team. They got their first district win against the Lockhart Lions. They came out on top 17-3. Jacob Layton, he led the team with 76 total yards and 16 out of 25 passing attempts, which is really good for a sophomore quarterback. He's really been showing out really well. And then on the rushing side, we had Jacob Layton with 128, and then Fisher Middleton with 104 right behind him, with a team total of 266. So that offense has really been picking it up and doing a great job showing out each night. On the defensive side, they held the Lions to just an extra point, which is an amazing and outstanding withstand against a great team. So Peyton Rice led with 20 tackles. Dalton Counts had 12. Connor Shear had 13. Hayden Barnett with 10. And Micah Harrison with 13. And Hayden Barnett was also nominated for the John Wynn Player of the Week, which is a huge honor, and led those polls really well. Luke Johnston also had an interception to end off the game and to put those Lions away right at the end. And Connor Shear and Hayden Poe also ended the game with one sack each. And then Zach Donaldson also had two kicking attempts and made them both, which is really good for a junior kicker who's just coming right off after following in some great footsteps of Jared Zirkel. Next, we have our cross country. Hannah Espinall finished fourth in the 2 mile run, and Mackenzie Caraway finished fifth in the 2 mile run. So way to go, ladies. And then we had in the men's 3 mile run, we had Luke Rossi, the little brother, coming over the top of Ethan Rossi. Luke finished second and Ethan finished third. Always a great rivalry every week. Those two have been showing out extremely well. And in the women's 3 mile open, Hannah Espinall finished first and Kendall Turner finished second. So great job, ladies. Way to keep going and keeping strong in that Tyvee cross country team. Lastly, we have the Antlers versus the Lobos. They faced them already and took it to them the first time. And they faced a little bit of a challenge this time coming back at them. But they ended up pulling it out in the end. Tyvee overall is 10-6. And in district, they're 6-4. And Lobos were 4-11 and 1-8 in district. So Tyvee's really been doing really good. And their volleyball team is really looking to go the distance this year. And they've been playing their butts off. So way to go, girls. And that seems like it wraps it up for here.
Welcome back. Free breakfast and lunch starting Monday, October 19th. All students will receive free breakfast and lunch for the remainder of the semester. A la carte items will still be available for sale. Come enjoy breakfast and lunch with us. We are happy to see our Tyvee students.
Now listen up. 10th and 12th grade students, if you're interested in taking that ASVAB test on November 10th, you should sign up with Mr. Milner in the counseling office. See, the ASVAB test is great. It's free, it gives career information, and a score that will be used to qualify a student for the military. Back to you, Indigo.
AP Honors. on Rams, UT dual credit students, be sure to make your payment for your classes to Mr. Grimella in the counseling office. AP students, you can still register for AP exams in May. Registration form and payment need to be turned in to Mr. Grimella. To close Channel 68 News out this week, here are some of the homecoming carnival highlights.
It's all right.